Welcome back, students. For this session, we are going to start the basic functions of CAS, functions of computerized accounting system. So, a quick recap about things that we have dealt in now. We have seen what is the definition of computerized accounting. Then we went ahead with the importance of the CAS, the minimum human intervention. Then we went ahead with the features of CAS. So till now, we know that, we have covered that CAS, what is CAS, and what are the characteristics or the features of CAS. With this, we get an idea about what it is all about. Now, moving ahead regarding the functions or the activities of CAS. What is this particularly? So here you can see accounting software is used to perform the functions of accounting. The activities are. So functions of accounting, nothing but the accounting cycle that we have discussed earlier. In accounting, what all do we do? Similarly, in a computerized accounting, what are the activities or the functions that is usually carried out? And for what all purposes do we use the softwares, accounting softwares? Okay. As you go point by point, you will understand what those functions are. Coming to the first one, online input and storage of accounting data. Okay. So this means online input and storage of accounting data. The first point. So we know that computerized accounting we use for all the accounting methodologies or the activities, but using a software wherein it is more automated procedure, except for the minimum human activities that we are supposed to do. The rest of it is more or less automated. So online input and storage of accounting data implies that we are going to not have any more books or records, but everything would be put. All the details will go as an input into our computer, and that software will analyze the data. Whatever is the data, obviously it pertains to accounting. And once we have the accounting information, we have the storage and the input as well. That means we are going to put in the data, which will obviously be the input for the particular software. And with that, what are you doing? You're going to analyze those transactions. And then further, you are going to store them as well. So online input and storage of accounting data. That is what the primary function would be. We are going to put in all our information. Second point, the processing of financial information. This point we have seen earlier also. We are not going to record any activity of the business in our accounting system, be it manual accounting system or computerized accounting system. You know very well that we take financial transactions into our accounting. Okay, so any kind of agreement, tenders, all those will not be a part of our accounting cycle because they are not the financial information. If we are having some tender details that we have been doing, it is part of our business. It is our business to speak to our supplier and try to handle the business. But only the financial part relating to this tender agreements with the supplier would be reflecting in our accounting. So that is the second point that we are referring to, processing of financial information, just like in MAS or CAS, both the things, it is the same thing, it's financial data only. Then what do we do? Print out of vouchers and invoices. In our MAS, that is manual accounting system, you know that all these details, whatever we are doing, the billing will be handmade. The accounting record is also handmade. Only the information, every detail is only like man-made activities. Here, computerized accounting system, the major advantage is we get a printout of vouchers and invoices. Firstly, why do I say it is major invoice in two methods, in two ways. Firstly, it gives the most systematized method of your business, which means that we are doing business, yes, of course, but in a more developed version rather than just a handmade bill. It is always nice to see that an organization or any shop, anything is giving its bill in the form of a voucher which is printed. Okay? That shows you are living up to the expectations of the modern world. Secondly, it is beneficial from the point of invoices or vouchers within the accounting system. That means the wheel that you have seen earlier, the initial step of voucher, that is billing the transaction, is the most important step of CAS. Once that activity is done properly, then the rest of it is automated. So now here, this vouchers and invoices are, that is the reason, it is in two ways. One, for the external way, how we look into the business, how we are trying to adapt to the modern world of business is what is reflecting from the external point of view. And internal point of view, from the business point of view, these vouchers and invoices will help us keep a track of ourselves, and inputting these devices will help in the further process of the CAS. Okay, so these are the functions of CAS, the activities which are done, printout of vouchers and invoices. Next, the fourth one, printout of ledgers and other books of accounts. So now see, in MAS, manual accounting system, if any person has to see one of the rules of business, you know that if the companies have to display the information which is right to the people, it has to, if it is one old system, traditional system, it is such a tedious job. You have to give reports in a different method which is accepted by people and all. This activity of publishing your information, financial position, is very wise, right from mid-scale business to large-scale business through CAS. Because any report that we want which relates to ledgers, any reports relating to the journals or any statements, balance sheet, all these details are very easy once we have the option of CAS, that is computerized accounting system, because everything, if you want, you can take as it is as a printout, or there is also a version where you can convert your information which is there in the software according to the need you want for the client. For example, if my customer, my supplier is asking that, let me check what are the activities that I dealt with you for this particular month. That means I have to show him all the details relating to that particular supplier. What all items did I purchase? When did I purchase? All these information. If you have to show that, imagine manual accounting system, you have to show your ledgers, your books. You have to keep that in front of them so that the people can assess. Okay? But now they can either take a printout of all those transactions and give it to him if he wants document wise, or it can be converted into Excel sheet wherein all the information is visible in the form of spreadsheet, and it can be easily mailed to the customer. Okay, so all these activities relating to the ledgers, the printouts and everything is also very possible and is a part of a CAS. Not only just the accounting procedures, all these are also available as part of the activities of computerized accounting system. Okay, so next step, updating of customer's account in sales ledger and supplier's account in purchases ledger. This is a very good point, and more often you will keep listening to these details, okay, as you go further. Customer's account, supplier's account, all these details. Let me first start this point with an example. I run a business. So if imagine, treat me as X trader. Now, if I have to do business, that means that I have to have a particular supplier and then a customer. Okay, just bear with me. I will show you. So as I said, the example that we were taking, imagine I am X traders. All right, when I have to perform business, say like a retailer, okay, I am a retailer. Now that means I have to purchase my goods from some particular person. Who would be my supplier? What would he become? He would become a creditor for us, from whom I make my purchases. Alright, next. As a retailer, when I'm doing my business, obviously not just the purchases, I have to take care of the sales as well. So I will also have a customer. Now that customer will be, what will he be? He will be my debtor. And so that would account to my sales. All right. So now when I'm doing this, what happens? My purchaser would send some goods to me. And then later part, I would send the same goods, a part of the goods or a part of the manufacturing products, or maybe into another process where I am going to just supply the another person who is going to further produce that or further manufacture that. It could be anything, but ultimately that person will become what he will just become a customer for us. He could do anything with that. He might not be the end user. He might just be some other producer as well. But for me, I would simply take these goods from the creditor and then send it over to the customer, which is more like a middleman. Okay. But of course, I have my business activities. Okay. So now this is what we are talking about over here. Updating of customer's account in sales ledger and supplier's account in purchases ledger. Now what happened earlier? Now, if I have, obviously, if, when I'm dealing with the as a business person, I'm not just going to deal with one product. Okay. I'm going to deal with many products. So with that, what happens? I will have a lot of suppliers for me. Supplier one, supplier two, then supplier three. Okay. There will be so many suppliers for me. At the same time, this one product that I have purchased from one particular supplier, I might be giving it to many customers. It is not just one customer that I'm giving. I might be giving it to customer A, customer B, or even customer C, part of the products. So what is basically happening over here? One product I have to purchase from someone, another product from another, which means I am going to have a lot of suppliers. Similarly, when I am having customers, there is not just one customer. There are a lot of customers. So imagine every time in an accounting procedure, if you have to, I would open one book for one particular customer because I don't want to have the confusion. So I would put them as, Sun Traders, if I take Sun Traders, then Vidyan Traders, another person. So I am going to maintain their books like that, which is going to be tedious. In a computerized accounting system, what happens is all of these customers, suppliers that we have can be clubbed into one category. They will be clubbed into one category. Similarly, all the customers of ours are also grouped into one category. They will be customers, that is debtors. All right. And similarly here, suppliers, So they will be creditors. So all my creditors will have one name and one group under them. All right. That is what we are talking about this point. So all the sales that I do, once invoice I would make. So X supplier, as an X business person, now I have purchased from, say, B trader. When I make a voucher, I would say I have purchased goods from whom I have taken from B, who is my supplier. Okay. And then I make, when did I purchase? What quantity did I purchase? And what is the rate of that particular purchase? I mean, each item. Then what is the GST relating to that? All these details, I would put it into my invoice. That is my purchase invoice. So this, what happens now when I hit that, I need to first create, not everybody will be automatically there in the software. When I'm creating my software and when I'm opening my account, I would create what is called as ledgers, which are already there. This is the main chapter you're going to talk about, the chart of accounts. We will come to that point later. These are all grouped. So what happens when I'm purchasing from B traders, I have to put them under one category. Who are these B traders? What are they to your business? You have to feed that information to the computer. So when I'm taking from B, I would create first their account. Okay. This is where the accounting knowledge is must. One small mistake as B traders you take, instead of putting them into your suppliers details, that is creditors, if you put them as debtors, the whole invoicing is wrong. Till your balance sheet, the whole information will reflect the amount as an asset rather than a liability. If you're purchasing from them, you have to pay them. But if you put them as debtors, they are supposed to give it to you. This is completely wrong. Okay. So this is where we say that invoicing is the most primary and the most important factor. So all these details, when you're filling in that invoice, the rest of the steps, that is the customer's details, the supplier's details, the ledgers, everything will get automated. So when I put B traders, sundry creditors, the date I purchased, this much quantity, it will go into the group. It will go into the group of sundry creditors or the creditors list. And then it would be reflecting till my balance sheet, my liabilities. If you make a mistake of debtors and creditors, it will be reflecting on your asset side, which is not giving the correct financial position of your business. Do you understand? So this is the most important step about invoicing. So relating to that itself, updating of customer's account in sales ledger and supplier's account in purchase ledger would happen automatically provided you give the right information when it comes to the invoice. Okay. But however, computerized accounting does all these ledger things automatically. It is automated procedure. So one of the important activity of accounting where journal from the journal entry used to take to the ledger and then again post them into the P&L and to the balance sheet, everything, which is all automated now because of computerized accounting system. Okay, so these are the first few points. Next, recording of bank receipts. Bank receipts, that means any transactions that we do need not necessarily be in the form of cash. It could always, the middle scale and the large scale businesses go for a lot of checks transactions or any other kind of, any other means of online transactions as well. So all these receipts, bank receipts that we have, that is also a part of accounting. And this accounting procedure is automated when we are receiving payments from our customers or when we are making transactions. There is facility in these computerized accounting softwares that if you give the details about the check that is involved in that particular invoice, it would update the bank account as well, showing us the information about what amount has been paid, through which check, to whom, on what date, and you can go till the invoice when you click on that particular banking transaction. So that recording of banking receipts is also easy and much comfortable with in computerized accounting systems. Now this helps a lot in maintaining our records, not only from the accounting point of view, but from our cash flow and keeping a track of our bank and cash accounts as well in an easy way. Okay, this particular thing is quite useful, or mostly used very effectively, in what we call as QuickBooks software. That is one of the softwares of accounting system, and in that QuickBooks, in and out, people use this cash and bank transactions, and it helps a lot to know what amount has to be paid, when it has to be paid, whether it is we have to receive or we have to pay, all these things which are done very effectively. Now, next point, writing day books and general ledger. So all these steps is skipped almost in our computerized accounting system, because we are not doing any kind of manual methods. All the activities of accounting have become more faster and more systematic and easy for us. So all these books, when we just do the bookkeeping in accounting, which means the basic transactions, everything else, the ledger formation and the other statements are all more automated. So this is part of that information, where our day books and general ledger is also maintained automatically. Next, maintenance of stock accounts. We have dealt about this in features also. Stock accounts, that is our, not only our business transactions relating to the purchase, sale and other things. It also gives us the details about bank details. And now the second one is inventory, stock. So it gives us the information about what stock is available, how much is available, or what is going to expire, or what has to be returned because of damage. All these details also can be loaded, or the maintenance of stock is easier through computerized accounting system. Now, stock accounts is not a part of a function. You need to understand this point. MAS has that is manual accounting system, does not give us the maintenance of stock accounts. If you remember, we have to do that manually over there. So one of the activities of accounting system, which is going a little out of the way and giving us the benefits of bank details and stock account details, especially stock. Even bank, probably we could again hold on to a different ledgers manually. But stock is definitely not possible in any other format except for the computerized accounting. So maintenance of stock accounts also is a function now of computerized accounting system. Age debtor summary. This is a very good point. Now, every time when a particular person has to pay us some money, what we have to do, we have to keep a record of that. Again, maybe some people go for an idea where they maintain another book which gives us the information about who has to give us the money, within how many days, is the deadline approaching. All these things have to be manually done. And there is definitely scope for error because it is a human intervention. But what happens in case of computerized accounting system? Aged debtor summary is given as an activity of accounting system. What does this mean? That means any debtor, any customer who is supposed to give us money, who owes his money, if he gives us the prompting and details about that particular person. This particular trader is supposed to give us this much of money relating to this invoice. The deadline is approaching. All this information is at one particular place of the software, where just by one click, you will get to know all the debtor details and who has to pay, how much, is the what is the deadline. Do we still have time to ask them, or Can we now ask them all these details? So aging debtor summary is available, which shows the summary about debtors who need to pay us. This is definitely not available in a manual accounting system. Preparation of trial balance, P&L, and balance sheet. This is an activity of MAS and CAS as well. Preparation of the trial balance, P&L, and balance sheet is more automated in computerized accounting system. Stock valuations, more about, you know, related to this stock valuations. When we are maintaining, we will know what are the stock available, and all the value related to the stocks. Okay, if it is say manufacturing, then how much of stock is work in progress, how much of stock is in raw material state, how much of stock is maybe, you know, if it is a retailer, then how much of stock is there in our godowns, and how much of stock is ready for expiry date. All these kind of valuations, also monetary valuations, also can be done. It is one of the activities or functions of computerized accounting system. Next, payroll analysis. Payroll, nothing but relating to the human resource of a business, which means nothing but, in simple terms, what we understand as employee maintenance, that is the analysis of the payments or the salaries to be paid to the employees. So who are the employees? How much are, what is their payment methodology? How much to be paid? And is there any due? Is there any other activities that have to be given to them? Say, for example, if it is any commission employee, so what are we dealing with that particular person as? What commission is there? Any changes in the commission after 2 years? All these details relating to our employees, whether it is on a contract basis, whether it is on a regular basis, who are they, and how much are we supposed to give them? All these details you can put. There is a different department. Next, you will see, when you see the components of accounting system, you will see that each department will have all those activities are here also. So all the details relating to an employee is this payroll analysis. So now all my employee details will easily be available under this particular system. Statutory returns such as GST and service tax. So we know that computerized accounting system not only gives the information about our accounting activities, it also gives us the required documents for filing our taxes. GST, we file in a particular different section. But all the information related to the tax, or any kind of tax, goods and services tax, or just the service tax, the details relating to the taxes is available to us in one particular section called the taxes section. Okay, so our reports, GST reports. Once you enable that GST, if you are eligible for GST, once you enable that tax section, giving your tax ID details, now you will have a section of GST, which means what tax for each invoice is coming, and whether it is central tax or whether it is state tax, all these details relating to the tax are also segregated properly and then put into the tax reports. Now, all that you need to do from this thing is just pick those reports, put it into the portal, the website where you have to file the returns, and then pay the tax, which is much easier than the traditional methodology, where there was scope for a lot of errors. Of course, you need to remember that computerized accounting system, tax is very easy for us to get the information. But it is our duty to check whether the initial transactions are properly made. Like I said earlier in the example, if your creditor, if you are misplaced into a debtor, first of all, your further transactions is not possible. If you have not given the details about a supplier, how will you make a sale? There itself, there is a step. But God knows if the accountant is not very well versed and he does not even try to relate it, but just picks up some stock which is coming into your screen and send it off, there is a total mess. You will still get your reports. You will still get your P&L. You will still get your balance sheet, but which is a lot of mistakes. and you are the one who is going to suffer for it. Everything is shown as a asset to you. There is no liability, which is not possible. So your whole auditing, your tax, and everything is going to be a mess. Okay. So these are the functions, or the activities of the CAS, computerized accounting system. The next step or the next topic is much easier for us, because once you understand the features, once you understand the functions, it is very easy for us to understand the next step, which is nothing but which is showing us the components or the subsystems of accounting, computerized accounting. So here it is. In short, for your to understand it in an easy method, this is nothing but, let us take like departments. Okay, if we have an organization, we will have each department. What are those departments? Say if you see any for your easy understanding, if you take into an office, if for an office, first of all there should be some location, then after that hiring will be done by human resource department, then giving the activities will be done by the process department, and any quality checks will be done by the quality department. Sales, any sales, if it is involved, it will be done with the by the sales department, and all these details like that. In an office, each department has a relevant task, and all those tasks will be done by that particular department. So to understand easier, this components is nothing but the departments, like the departments, sections in computerized accounting system. So if you try to correlate these points, which are features, so all these are what activities or the functions of CAS, which is all these vouchers, updating stock, and all these details. Where it is done? It is done in different components or subsystems of computerized accounting system. So we have a subsystem for cash and bank. We have subsystem for sales accounts receivable. Okay. So here we know that each one is self-explanatory. Cash and bank system, sales, then inventory, purchase, payroll. I was telling employee, all the details about the employees, payments, and all that will be done in this payroll accounting system. So each system is there. Basically, you will see a screen later. Each one will have a particular screen. So like, I have to go to my sales, it will give me the details about the sales. I have to go to my purchases, it will go. There is a display screen, and that will lead you to look at all your subsystems. Okay. Similarly, when you are entering an invoice also, all these subsystems will give the name, their name, in the form of ledgers. So there is a cash ledger, there is a bank ledger, sales ledger, all these ledgers are there, startup accounts. When you pick them from that and make an invoice, so what happens? I made a transaction in the sales. I took the sales ledger name and put it in my invoice and made my sales invoice. So what happens when I press enter and I've made the transaction? It will automatically go to the subsystem of sales, and it will be reflecting over there. And also the related accounts of that particular sale. Because sales means automatically there will be a customer. Customer means debtor. Okay. So all the relevant accounts also will be reflected. So all the different departments. Now fixed assets. Obviously when I make a furniture purchase, so my fixed assets subsystem. Then expenses. All the P&L activities like electricity, stationery, all these things. Expense accounting subsystem, tax, GST, service tax, any other taxes, all this. Final accounting, my balance sheet place. Costing, which shows me different details about, working capital or any other ratios that I want. Even that is there. Budgeting, capital budgeting, any other investment. All these details also will be shown to me if I want to analyze my business. Okay, management information system, complete information about all the activities which are related to the management. If a management has to take a decision, okay, what are the profits now till this particular year? Is it more than the previous year? Have we recovered anything? Or what is the employee status now? how many people are bad employees or not updated employees, I mean. Do we have to take updated employees? What is the productivity out from the employees? All these information relating to the management, if a department, higher authority has to take the decisions, then it needs a lot of information. Productivity of that particular person, how will you measure? Through the financial ways he's doing. How much of productivity relating to one particular employee? What is the cost? How much of salary we are paying to that particular employee? So all these details, which will come in the form of many other subsystems, will be available in our management information system as well. Okay? So in short, as I was saying, it is nothing but a like a department. Now this is the screen I was mentioning, telling you about. See, this gateway of Tally, this you are going to see it this you are going to see it on a regular basis, gateway of Tally. Now this software, Tally is a software, firstly, to give you information. This is the software which we are going to refer to in your particular course. There are, as I said, a lot of softwares available, but we will be handling with Tally relating to your subject. Now, Gateway of Tally is like the first screen. It is the first screen of your company. Once you create your company, now what, where should I go? Like how you have your first screen, say in any social profile, your first screen will be there, and from there you will have a lot of other links. Similarly, this is the first screen which will give you the information about your company. From here you can go anywhere. Now you can see different subsystems. So all the subsystems you can see through this display screen. When you go to the display and you click on that, you will go to other further details. And some, most of the information will be available on the right side also, like how we have over here. A lot of information will be over here through different functions. So what, which key? Say for example, F3. When I press F3 in this particular screen, it will give me the company information, my profile. Okay, like that. This every screen will give you information about where you are headed to and what is this particular information, what that this particular function does. Okay, now here if you see reports also, I have balance sheet, profit and loss, stock summary, ratio analysis, remember the earlier point. So all these are available, my accounting vouchers, import data, banking, audit and compliance. So every detail, this is the first screen that I have, and I have to go for any voucher entries that I have to make a purchase or a sale, I will go to my accounting vouchers. Okay. Even if you have to edit, if you have to delete, you have to make another one or modify anything, all this you'll have to go here only, and then further go for whatever you want to edit or create or delete. Okay. This will be more like a gateway for you. So now if you look at the previous three, so all the cash, bank, sales, inventory, all this will be over here. You will go to your relevant information and then click on that, you will go to the further details. Okay. And the last topic for today, the CAS application. That means in a computerized accounting software, obviously, in a software also, there will be different applications. So when it comes to the accounting software, accounting system, what applications do we have? It is nothing but, you know, if you have to get in connection with this component, the subsystems that we were talking about, just in relation to that. So if we want all these departments, that means we need to install that particular application into the software. Okay, if you understand that language. Or in simple terms, our departments, this departments have to come into place. That means we need a particular, financial amount catering to that particular department and this particular department everywhere. Then our departments are ready. Similarly, in a software, if you understand, in a software to put, you need to put some applications, and only then the applications, each one will have separate sections and separate departments. So what are those separate CS applications? One is transaction processing. So for every invoice, vouchers, anything, we need one application. So that will be the transaction processing. Payroll accounting, the employees. So we have dealt about payroll, employees details, what the salary details, commission, whether it is contract basis, whether it is permanent basis, all the information relating to the employees categories will come under payroll. Okay. Then debtors accounting, stores accounting. So debtors accounting, all those people who have to give us, or who are basically our customers, or who have to give us some money. So all those people, we give the details over there. Stores accounting, that is all the inventory information, for all that information. So let us finish this, and then I'll give you one classic example to understand what it is. Preparation of various types of budgets, be it working capital, all those financial budgeting, or any other ratio analysis, all these details for that, another application. And finally, preparation of financial statements. So these are the complete applications. Now, a simple example to understand what is it. I, as I told you earlier, I am a ex-trader. So I do a business. I take from another purchaser, I mean our supplier, and then I give it to another retailer. So what do I do in a computerized accounting system? I make an invoice. From my invoice, all other retails are automated. So, but while putting that invoice into my accounting system, there should be one place where it will connect everything. That means I have to put an invoice. That means I have to take the details about the supplier and everything, all these details. Then I have to talk about what is the quantity and everything, which means about stock details. Then when I put the invoice, my ledger is automatically updated. My other details, financial statements are also updated. So all these to come into place, there should be some base. There should be some base. How is the operating possible? That is what is we are talking about. So for all the departments to function, or all the functions of CS be possible, these are the CS applications. Okay. We will end the topic over here. Next session, we will go ahead with pre-CAS factors or requirements. That is, before even we go for CAS, computerized accounting system, what are the requirements for a business to to be feasible to go into CAS? Okay. Thank you.